All right, good morning. I want to introduce Isidro Lazo. Isidro is the head of Startup Europe, that is the initiative hosted and run by the European Commission for all the activities for startups. So we've been here for a full day. Yesterday also you participated to the Go Global Now initiative. And I think there are two areas where I would like your thoughts. And number one, the kind of making the world of Europe as a commission closer to startup. That's I think one topic. And the second one is again about building bridges. I'm sorry, that's all I do for a living, building bridges. The second one is the building bridges between the corporations and the startup. So along the two topics, I would like your, you know, a little bit of your view of what can be done better to make the worlds of you know, grassroots innovation closer to the options that that the European Commission is providing.
Yeah, I think we are talking in both cases about building bridges between the European Commission, the EU institutions, and startups, and building bridges between corporates and startups. So essentially, the way forward that we have thought in the Commission is try first to speak the same language they speak. So not try to reduce to the minimum possible the jargon that we have to use as a legal public administration. Second, try to go where they are, try to go where the startups are, instead of organizing our own events in Brussels or in the any other place in Europe, try to go where the startups are already going there and try to speak to them while they are there. And third thing we are doing is try to liaise with the leaders, the opinion leaders, the opinion creators, the major tech media blogs, the most prominent figures in this ecosystem. So that through these people, we are trying to reach out to the massive amount of startups. These are the three approaches we are using, and I hope corporates should use, I hope they will also use similar approaches, going where they are, trying to understand the language that they speak, and finally, of course, try to also engage, liaise with the opinion leaders, like the guys that we were talking before, Mike Butcher from the Crans, Martin Bryan from the NestWeb, David Kaff from EG Gaon, et cetera, so that the startups know the wonderful things that corporates are doing. Most of the startups don't know those things. I didn't know it before today. I have to be honest about that. So I think there is a problem here of mismatch of information between the corporates and the startups. So a similar approach, similar strategic approach could be followed in both cases to build bridges.
So I have to say I've been impressed in seeing that somebody that is coming from Brussels at the kind of that kind of environment, you know exactly what the Lean Startup methodology is all about. So you're getting out of the building. This rule number one, to get closer to actually your potential users and customers that are the startups and the corporate. So I think that it was a great example of a showing that this is not just talk, but it's actually walking. You're walking the talk. So one of the ideas that was surfaced yesterday, and I thought it was pretty interesting because we were doing it as a, you know, an exchange of opinions at a friendly environment, was, you know, to mix and match, you know, to swap positions, to understand the other side of the table much better. And so do you want to share what you've been doing hosting, you know, an entrepreneur within the bureaucratic environment and the option to have the opposite, so having some of the you know, commissioners just sitting with startups for some a limited amount of time, but to understand really the dynamics?
Yesterday we were talking about entrepreneur in residence. Is something that some governments are doing, like the UK, like the United States. In the Commission, we have also one entrepreneur in residence within the Startup Euro team. And it's a way for us to listen to the voice, to give voice to this community directly in our meetings. These entrepreneur in residence, they sign a kind of disclosure agreement, et cetera, so that they can participate in our internal meetings, they can give us their opinion about what we are doing right or wrong. So this is something that I believe all public administrations, big or small, local or national public administrations, should certainly benefit from these kind of things. And the second thing that we are not doing, but we know that some countries, or at least one country in Europe is doing, Romania, is taking civil servants and putting them in residence in a startup. This is something we have not tried, but I promise Marco that I'm going to try it to see if they get the approval of the hierarchy for these kind of things. But I think that that could be doable.
All right, why don't we share some numbers, two things. One, some numbers that you can share about now the whole ecosystem in Europe. You can, you know, slice and dice it as you wish, but maybe the app economy is a good proxy.
Yeah. Yeah, evidence gathering is one of the major problems in Europe. We don't have in Europe, like in the States, the Kauffman Foundation, etc., which is collecting a lot of figures. So we started to collect figures, and the last figures we have collected, we have got from a study that the Commission has funded and has been carried out by Giga On Pro and the Derry University of Ireland, is about the app economy. The app economy in Europe has a workforce of 1.8 million people in Europe, and with the potential to grow in 5 years to 4.8 million. No other sector in Europe has this potential. And in terms of revenues, they are getting currently 17.5 billion euros to grow in 5 years to 63 billion. And what is most important is that we are competitive. We are getting as much in terms of revenues as the Americans. We are getting, both of us are getting 42%. This is something, we were not expecting this figure. We thought in particular in the comparison that with the States that we were much worse, but no, we are quite well positioned in the app economy in particular in terms of revenues and competitiveness. So it's certainly this kind of evidences is something that we are sharing with the member states, so that it's clear that the if we are talking about creating jobs, certainly the app economy should be one of the ways forward.
Just a very last one. Yesterday you showed a place where all the startups and accelerators can find real opportunities for them in the web. That's one of the issues that sometimes it's kind of hard to surface that kind of content. You want to tell the listeners to where to go?
Yeah, there is a website of the Commission that you can reach through by typing startupeurope.eu, and then you go there. And then you will see there a lot of activities. Sorry that there are so many things, but we always prefer to have all the things there that just done to select. So you go there, you can see funding opportunities. There are, for example, 850 million in 2014 to be allocated through Horizon 2020 and COSME to SMEs and startups. And there are networks of accelerators, networks of co-working spaces, networks of investors that you can also reach from Napoli and from anywhere in Europe. So you have there a summary of all the, a list of all the things we are doing in the Commission for Startups.